Hi, welcome to the statics tutorials. So for this problem, we have a system where we have a beam that's at an angle. It has a moment on it at this end of 50 newton meters in the clockwise direction. We have 75 newtons acting down, and then we have 100 newtons at this far end acting at 50 degrees. So we want to replace all the loading on this beam with one single resultant force, and then we're being asked to find the horizontal distance from the edge over to the resultant force. So to do this, we want to first find the resultant. We can find the resultant by making the sum of forces be the same in both systems. So if we do sum of forces over here, we'll have the x component of the 100 newton force, so that would be 100 newtons times sine of 50. The x component here is the side that's opposite to the 50 degree angle. X component's going in the positive x direction, we get positive 76.6 newtons. We can do sum of forces in the y direction. Here we'll have the negative 75, and then we'll have the negative 100 times cosine of 50. We're using cosine because the y side touches the angle, it's adjacent to the angle. Add that all up and we get negative 139 newtons. So this is our resultant here, and we can write the resultant as the 67.6 newtons I minus the 139J and bracket it and put the unit outside. So now let's see if we can figure out this distance. We need to make the sum of the moments match between this system and this system for these systems to be mathematically equivalent. So over here, the sum of the moments, we have the 50 newton meter moment. By the right-hand rule, that's negative or clockwise. The 75 newton force is acting in the y direction, so we'll multiply it by its x distance back over to O. And then we have the 100 newton force that has both the x and the y component. So for the y component here, we're going to multiply that by this x distance of 5 meters. For this x component here, we're going to multiply it by its y distance of 4 meters. You can see that the x component is going to have a negative moment about O, and the y component is also going to have a negative moment about O. Summing it all up, we get negative 903 newton meters, and then we're going to say that negative 903 newton meters is going to be equal to the y component of FR, because the x component is going to go through point O over here, so the y component of FR times the x distance of the y component back over to O. Then we can solve for x, and we get 6.48 meters. Now this might seem odd because this distance was only 5 meters, so that means that this force is actually shifted off the beam over here. But that's okay in this system. We're just doing mathematical equivalence. And because we have an extra moment here, that's going to tend to shift that force out further. And we have a force that's acting at the end here. We have an x force and a y force really sitting down here at the end, and so that's also going to tend to shift that FR out a little bit. So this is a reasonable result. Thanks for watching.